now. Mm. I think LGD are by far and away the second best team in the LPL, but we're into game two already, OMG versus IG, and this might tell us who's the fourth best team in the league.
Yeah, it certainly might. Oh my gosh, versus Invictus Gaming. Shen, first ban away for Zetai. Maokai, banned away from Xiong. And Ekko, banned away from Kakao. Nobody wants to mess with that once again.
Yeah, well, they just... Ekko performs the duty of Soul Tank really well. Like, he has a huge shield, a zoning tool that goes with it. His third strike that gives him the movement speed boost is actually a pain in the backside to deal with late game because of how he darts around teamfights. And as I said, like, with Lulu in the game, you legitimately have to kill the man three times before he actually dies. Mm. He's a very tricksy street urchin, and he's probably where he deserves to be right now in the ban bin.
Yeah, certainly in that slot. Next ban is going to be taking away Kalista. Vayne, respect banned away from Kid, and Ryze is the forced answer out of Invictus Gaming.
Yeah, so I don't want to give Xiong a mage up there in the top lane. No surprise there. He's a fantastic Syndra player, but we're not going to say that at all. And would not be surprised if it was the Gragas that gets picked up here by Lovely. Mm-hmm. Opens up E for Kakao, because there will be no Rek'Sai in the game. But wouldn't... Yeah, he's going to lock it in.
Yeah, decides to commit to the Gragas. Zetai running through the good old-fashioned randomizer to see
what... Oh, no, this is his champion.
It can run with...
Oh, good, good. Yeah. You know, he's probably played all those champions at some point in his career.
Yeah, Azir now being looked at by Rookie. Very strong on that champion, while Zetai continues to scroll through his champion pool. I saw Poppy in there. Likely not going to see that this time
Chachi
around.
Played Poppy last week. Maybe it was this week.
Oh, yeah, it was. You're right. Oh, my gosh.
Poppy's still very much in the meta.
Oh, yeah.
They lost horribly.
Just not this meta.
Spoiler alert.
Elise now being looked at by Zetai. Again, this is 513, so she has not received her stun and Spiderling buffs just yet.
When she does, I guarantee that someone will pick her up top lane. I've been... There are rumors abound.
Rumblings?
Yeah, the Elise top is back.
Oh my
gosh.
And
I dislike it a lot.
I cannot wait. I'm an Elise main. I've probably put in like 600 games on that champion.
Her jungle's really good.
Oh yeah.
Right now. I haven't played it top so far. I play it jungle as well, but top lane Elise was horrifying.
Oh my gosh. Abyssal Scepter, Rylai's Haunting Guys.
Yeah.
Legasp.
Exactly.
Oh my gosh, my mind is exploding. Champion. I need to go play solo queue right now. Do you think he can handle the...
Probably.
Yeah, okay.
Yep.
So Corki locked in along with Braum for Kid and Kitties. Again, Invictus Gaming putting priority on that duo lane bottom. They know that it's the strong answer.
Yeah, it's a swap from last lane game. It was North and Amazing that ran it last time around. Opens up blue AP Ezreal in the mid lane right now. Cool, looking at Kog'Maw, either for himself or for North. It could be either way. They could also run a Raise the Puppy comp right now, or a Juggamore, or whatever you like to call the...
Yeah, I like Raise the Puppy. Because then it's, is the puppy going to turn into like a tiny little...
Well, the puppy's Uzi, you know that, don't you? Like, so Uzi's
a puppy?
Uzi's old nickname was like the puppy. So whenever Starhawn Royal Club used to like have those team comps where they would just all play around Uzi, they called them the Raise the Puppy comp.
Oh man.
So you just raise him up, raise him up, raise him up, and then he would go berserk and carry you to two successful world finals.
Oh my gosh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
The more you know.
Chinese history lesson.
I just thought it was like a metaphor. Like Raise the Puppy. Is it going to be a little yipping schnauzer or is it going to be a Great Dane?
I don't know. What I like schnauzers more than Great Danes. Great Danes don't look like they could be like graceful enough around the...
They don't need to be graceful when they can knock over a full-sized human being.
That's true. Schnauzer would eat your socks, though.
Yes, he certainly would. There's Evelynn now locked in for Kakao, and Hecarim picked up for Zetai as an answer towards that Kog'Maw.
Yeah, so seeing whether they can get someone onto the backline to really distract the Kog'Maw. Wonder whether it's going to be a full tank Hecarim or whether it will be a Knight teleport, maybe Trinity Force Rush in there. As the counter pick now being considered by Xiong, probably one of his more undervalued top laners. He plays an okay Gnar up there.
We'll see how he manages to fare as he is going up against Zetai. And we didn't actually see a lane swap in the previous game. It was... Oh, no, we did. It was very early from... No, I'm totally getting my game.
Yeah, no, it was really early because, remember, Zatai died.
Yeah.
And then he jungle then followed back for like three levels, and then they swapped back immediately.
Yeah, so there was a lane swap for approximately 17 seconds.
Yeah, it was a little bit longer than that, but yeah, it wasn't very long coming through there. As we see a variant of, like, I guess, a Protect the Kog'Maw composition here, because North is going to be on it. He's got some good disengage coming out of all his members, but they're also legitimate threats in their own right.
Yep.
So, you know, you've got the Azir that can shove people back. You've got Gragas Barrel to knock people back. Also got Zhiyong on Gnar that can throw people away. But they also have the ability to combo their abilities to do a lot of damage. So good, I guess, variation of disengage. They've got the trinity of disengage champions. They've got the Azir. They've got Janna as well as Gragas. But also some good damage out of those solo laners.
Yeah, really looks like the multi-threat comp for OMG is the name of the game this time around. IG looking like they might go back to a Protect the Kid once again. But we'll see as Kitties swaps it around. Come on, go for the Karthus. Oh, might opt for the Kassadin instead. Yeah, he decides to lock it in. It's going to be Rookie's Kassadin versus Kool's Azir.
So right now, there are so many threats on the side of IG to deal with what OMG have brought to the table. You can get through onto Kool with a couple of different champions and wipe him off the map. Amazing against the Teleport Ignite Hecarim. North will not have a good time. Amazing probably won't care. He's Janna. He's just going to try and keep his AD carry alive. But right now, you got Evelyn, you got Hecarim, as well as the Kassadin, all looking for those flanks to start the team fights up. Straight 5v5. OMG should be able to hit the reset button enough times until they get it right. If they ever find little picks around Kakao's vision, this game will be very difficult for OMG to come through.
Yeah, we'll have to see if OMG can pull it off. You can see the players on your screen. Kid at the far end, grinning from ear to ear. Even the timely camera zoom to accentuate it just speaks to how confident IG are feeling into this one. OMG on the other side, not looking so happy with this, trying to take it seriously. In the top, it's Zhiyong versus Zatai, that Gnar versus Hecarim matchup.
So the counter matchup coming through here for Zhiyong, he's going to be able to build the Frozen Mallet, potentially maybe a Black Cleaver, and he's trying to shut that down. Loveling's got his Gragas against Kakao's Evelyn. We mentioned the fact that no Rek'Sai opens that one up as we see Azir versus Kassadin in the mid lane. And in the bottom lane, hyperscaling both Trinity Force users.
Yeah.
One of them does much better late game than the other, though. Kog'Maw versus Corki.
Yeah, so there might actually be a small fault in IG's team comp. If they've been playing exceptionally well with team fights, having a team comp that kind of tapers off at the end of team fights might be a bit dangerous. Oh, I am completely wrong. They have a Kassadin.
Yeah, they have a Kassadin and they have a Hecarim. Two really good anti-carries.
Yeah, so we're getting into game right now. Let's see if they can pull it off. Welcome back, everyone. This is week number 9, day number 3, set number 4, game number 2, 24 seconds in. It's OMG versus Invictus Gaming.
I think that was your quickest by like 12 seconds today.
Yeah.
Well done.
I usually try to get it done by about 23 seconds in.
Okay. You were like on 36 and 38 the first couple
of
times.
Yeah, I really kind of mucked
those up. Third time you like false started hardcore and I had to finish it off for you, so I'm giving you a DNF.
Yeah, well. Sometimes you have good games, sometimes you have bad ones. Defensive lines coming out of the two teams across the map. Nobody wants to take any chances with any sort of wacky play once again. Zatai won't have to burn any of his summoner spells early
on.
He can't
burn any of his summoner spells.
Yeah.
Teleport away?
He sees the body slam out of Loveland, then just takes it and teleports to his turret.
Yeah. As we saw game 1-2 kills going over at level 1. One onto, I think it was Loveling, one onto Rookie in the mid lane.
Yep.
And it looks like a lane swap going to be initiated by both teams.
Yeah. Lane swap match.
Kog'Maw's weird. Mm-hmm. Cool. So I like talking about Kog'Maw a lot. He's one of, I think, the... I like his design, both in AP and AD. And I love the fact that he's one of the few champions that we still see in both variations of his AD and AP self. Mm-hmm. Which means that he's quite well balanced, although next patch is extremely strong. But he is one of the best Trinity Force users in the game because he has a spammable ultimate. His W auto attack takes no skill whatsoever, and you're able to get the big Sheen proc off on it. So even though he's up against Corki, who once again arguably one of the best Trinity Force users in the game, Kog'Maw does relatively well, especially if you throw him with a lane bully like Janna. This should be quite a good lane for North and Amazing. You can see already they're moving up with that W with that Eye of the Storm.
Yeah, we didn't get to see the early boss bomb from Kid. There he goes. He only manages to clear one minion, so it looks like he might be having some trouble.
Wow, they're going to get shoved in. There is no way you trade with W with Eye of the Storm on North and Amazing right now. So he's just going to be relegated to farming as best as he can.
Yeah, fast reflexes from Amazing soaks the damage of that Winter's Bite. The farm fest continues in that duo lane. Meanwhile, Xiong is probably having the time of his life against Zetai, who did start off with the Direwolf camp and teleported down to the bottom side of the map. So he does have a minor experience advantage, but that's something you're desperately going to need against that mini Narform.
Yeah, it certainly is. It's just so annoying. It's like dealing with the worst of Teemo's and Cho'Gath.
Oh my gosh, I hate playing Cho'Gath so much.
I like the fact that you went with Cho'Gath over Teemo there.
I could deal with Teemo. Teemo's okay, because he's squishy. If you chunk Cho'Gath down to a third of his health, and then you don't have enough to finish him, he'll just farm and heal back up.
Yeah, so Trundle does that as well. I don't think he's different than Trundle.
It's tragic. I don't see a lot of time.
But do you know what I saw last night that I was very mad about?
Jump.
I'm an Ingen. That dude has no business being in top lane.
Oh,
it
man.
It destroyed me.
There have been so many good Reddit threads on Heimerdinger too. There have been some really great guides.
That must have been it. Please no more. That's lovely. Going for a bit of an early invade. We're seeing pretty standard lanes coming out here, guys, and not really much happening apart from some CS coming through. You see that already Zetai struggling in the mini Gnar lane. Lovely gonna kill himself a crab.
As to be expected, secures one Scuttle Crab. Actually headed down to that bottom side. Zetai trying to get some punishment onto Xiong, but he does have a health potion.
So you generally want to gank for your Hecarim early. The reason being is he has Ignite. And Ignite's a really good tool at killing people. But you can see that they expect something funny is going on.
Xiong bounces over Kakao with that enormous range and gets back to the safety of his turret.
Yeah, Zetai even misses a couple of creeps there, so no successful gank coming through. Xiong able to continue to bully this lane.
Very good attempt with the gank. I like the reaction just to seeing the empowered auto attack. Imagine if he had Sheen on top
of
that.
Yeah, I know. That's what, terrifying.
Would have been fantastic. Kakao with that early gank did seed some CS. Levelin actually has not recalled just yet and is now 8 creeps ahead. And those are jungle creeps and a scuttle crab, so we'll see if Kakao can make up for that gold deficit as there are some pings now onto Kool.
Kakao's doing the right thing. He's making sure that he's using that invisibility early on in the game.
Yeah, there goes the slow. A lot of damage. Kool, whoa, doesn't get the shield. Barrier, Ignite ticking away. Oh no, the last tick gets first blood onto Rookie. Loveland looks for a counter gank. They turn it around. The barrel finds the slow, but they decide not to die.
Yeah, so in the end.
Oh, in the top, Amazing is going low as well. Action across the map as IG pulled the trigger across three lanes.
Really nicely done there by Invictus to be able to dominate this bottom lane. You see they were playing with a larger minion wave and they just try and fight as Zetai also bullying out Xiong. Zetai wanted to ignite him there, you saw with the
Eon. Oh, he's got it. He's not going to pull the trigger, however. Kakao will. He finds Amazing, gets tagged with the winner's bike. The auto attack secures a kill. They're trying to juggle turret aggro. They succeed. Double kill Kakao. 3 kills IG.
Yeah, and all of a sudden, Kakao, who is, wow, the return kill coming through there with the explosive. So arguably for the bottom lane, better off coming through there for the Kog'Maw. But Kakao now, we mentioned the fact that he was down in CS and it wasn't a bad thing because as Evelyn, if you do not impact the lanes at the start of the game, you have this lull that comes through due to your reasonable, inefficient mid-game is what I'm going to call it. But if you get a couple of kills, you can start snowballing, pick up some AP items, maybe do some work.
Yeah, Rookie with the fast level 6 punishes Kool. Takes some punishment from the Sand Soldiers himself, turns it right back around. Could look for the solo kill. Is he going to dive here? There are 3 members. He gets the kill, but trades one back over.
Yeah, but Kassadin, 2 kills at this early in the game, definitely worthwhile for Rookie right now. The earlier he can start rolling, the better off the game is going to be for Invictus Gaming. And once again, they have the scaling comp coming around. Is Zetai going to take some punishment on the bottom side of the map? needs to get out of dodge as Loveling also behind him.
He runs the heck out of there. Loveling looks to steal away the Direwolf camp from Kakao, who's making up for the deficit by catching some CS in the mid. And when it's all said and done, it's 4-2 in favor of Invictus Gaming. They're 1,000 gold ahead, 2 kills on Kassadin, 2 kills on Kakao, a completely different style to game number one, and OMG, we're not prepared.
But an early counter jungle coming through here for Loveling. He's going to start off the blue buff. They recognize it because they've swapped the duo lane down on the bottom, so Kakao going to invade Loveling's blue buff in response, but level 6 reach for the Gragas before the Evelyn, even with all the early action.
Yeah, so the blue looks to be stolen. Kakao trying to see if he can find Xiong overextended.
Dive coming through in the bottom lane right now. The tie in trouble.
He's got his ultimate. Can he play this out right? Naka finds him. He's at half health, and he uses it as an escape.
Yeah, doesn't commit onto him, maybe. Doesn't want to give up the kill. So good choice there from Zasai to get away, but that will mean the first turret falls down in OMG's favor. They're also looking to grab themselves a dragon for their trouble.
Equalizes it in overall gold. And Grom camp stolen away by Kakao. This first dragon should be going down. No contest from OMG as they've got too many members on the top side of the map. Xiong successfully pulling attention away from the turret. It's not gone down quite yet, but it should be right now.
Yeah, so in the end, they're able to stack the wave up as well, which means it's going to push back in their favor. Allows Zatai to get some free CS for his time. And Loveling grabbed the blue buff on Invictus' side of the map, whereas Wookiee got it on OMG's side of the map. Wow.
They find Loveling tagging with the winner's fight. They just need 2 more auto attacks. Lower grows the Agony's Embrace. They're not going to find the stun, but they're continuing to chase. The last one stuns Achilles.
Gives him the
care.
Wrestle with Rom in the end, way too strong. That's an illegal move, but you know, if the referee doesn't see it, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, referee was too busy checking Twitter with that one. Didn't manage to find the kill onto Kid, but...
Checking Twitter, they're always distracted by managers. Come on, man.
Oh, yeah.
You gotta get your WWE. They didn't have mobile phones back then.
I never did watch WWE.
Oh, my head. We're done here. Pack it up, boys.
10 minutes into the game, IG with a solid 1,300 gold lead. Rookie having the time of his life on that Kassadin. Doesn't even have a Rod of Ages completed yet, and he's already bullying Cool out with that super fast blast.
Yeah, but he's going to go back and grab it now because it will start stacking up straight away. Generally, when you get things like here, like Roller, you want to buy it as soon as you've got the gold, even if it gives up a little bit of lane presence. Just because if you can get it stacking that minute or two early, you're going to make great things as the game goes on.
Yeah, so he is completing the recall right now. We'll see if he can quite finish it off. Zatai on the other side. Yep, 1,300 gold. Should be able to get that. Zatai does have a Phage now picked up on top of that Sapphire Crystal, so it looks like it will be Trinity Force first to deal with that Gnar. And we kind of talked about how Xiong would look to be a counter for that Hecarim during the laning phase. Well, he's down in CS right now, and the wave is pushing back towards Zatai.
And also going to, you know, maybe thought he was going to be stuck in the lane swap a little bit longer than what he was. But in the end, wasn't the case, and now he's given up a lot of his advantage. Rookie Kakao's behind him. Xiong in trouble once again.
Yeah, there goes a bounce. Xiong makes it to the minion wave, but again, he's targeted. Looks like he's going low. And Kakao, 3-0-2.
Yeah, having a great game, and you see that they put Rookie in the bottom lane, just allow him to free farm, turn the mid lane into a farm fest because they lost kill potential on Cool, as now he has the ultimate as well as the barrier backup available. So instead, just put your duo lane mid, see if you can siege up the turret with the Sheen, which is what should have happened last game for OMG. And right now it's IG accelerating appropriately. As we said, 5v5 teamfight probably going to be in OMG's favor. But as long as Kakao can get busy around the map, use this passive to the best of his ability, it's going to be a difficult mid game.
Yeah, he is all over the place so far, involved in 5 of his team's 6 kills in this 11-minute game. Rookie just bullies North. The completed Rod of Ages and Catalyst passive means he can continue putting that pressure out there despite North's best efforts. And really, if in game number one, Kid was the primary carry that they had decided on from the beginning, that he was going to be that hyper carry, this time around, it's definitely going to be rookie Kakao and Zatai. I mean, these guys are playing so exceptionally well in this match.
Yeah, exactly right. And you have a look at what they've picked in the bottom lane, it's going to be a Brid. They're going to be able to stop a lot of the damage with Kiddies, use the Trinity Force that comes out of Kid nice and early to get a mid-game power spike. As everyone's collapsing on Kid, Rookie right now, he's in some trouble.
Yeah, he does have his flash and the Rift Walk. He's going to have to outplay this one. Looks for a kill on the north, but jumps over the wall. This is a tricky spot for Rookie to be. He's spotted out by Loveland, saving onto it. Turns it around, looks for the kill on the north, but just doesn't have enough damage. There goes the Emperor's Divide. He's finally going to fall. Kakao has joined the battle. He's going to chase forward, knocked him to the turret. He's at low health, not very tanky. He goes low. He's still alive. Loveland flashes forward. There's the shutdown. Gold and IG have overstayed their welcome.
Yeah, a little bit of a misplay coming out of IG there. They send a tie down. He didn't have ultimate. No Trinity Force picked up yet on Kid. He couldn't join the fight at all. And the good rotation coming through from OMG guarantees that they pick up two kills. Still control this blue buff. Might lose the mid lane turret in response, which would not be good, but they stop the snowball for now.
Oh yeah, it's going to be close now that Cool has finally arrived here. Turret goes low, but isn't going to end up going down. OMG managed to keep it standing, and they get a foothold back into this game.
That's a nicely played out of Cool and Frenzy. You saw all rotating down as a unit. Definitely a good move there. The mid lane turret now under fire in response, although they all back away.
Counter rotation from OMG, not quite going to find the turret for Kakao, and Kid are defending it. Dragon's going to be up in 45 seconds. You just saw a ping come out from IG. They know that it should be up soon. I'm certain someone has that on a timer. As blue buff is going to go over to Cool this time.
Both blue buffs stolen away from Loveling. He's still having a great jungle performance. You know, we keep mentioning Kakao, but he's 3-0-0. Very nicely done by the Dragon's player. Max W first.
On the bottom side, farming it up. North and Amazing are there to catch the minion wave, but IG send Kakao and Kiddies. Kid has just completed his Trinity Force in time for this Dragon respawn, so IG are once again reared and ready to go for the rest of OMG.
They probably wanted on the tie before they fight, honestly. When you look at it, it's going to have much more of an impact if he's able to pick up the Trinity Force.
Deciding to get Zatai splitting on the other side of the map. He's buying some time as Xiong already used his own teleport a bit sooner to go for the gank onto Rookie. Vision now will spot out Loveling as Kakao just dancing around with that Evelynn passive as best he can. Zatai trying to pull someone away. He's going to get a chance to push this wave onto the turret. OMG, you need to pull the trigger.
Yeah, they certainly are wasting a little bit of time because of Kakao's split push coming through here. All of a sudden, Xiong must go back towards the top lane. Otherwise, Zatai will take that. If he's got enough gold right now for Trinity Force, he should honestly just go back.
Only at 800, not quite there just yet, so he's continuing to buy time, take some more punishment from Xiong with the pickaxe. Lots of damage as he looks to build that into a frozen heart. OMG looking for some action in the mid, can't quite find it.
Yeah, Frozen Melee going to come through. But wow, the big one connects there from Kid. So Frozen Melee going to be the pickup. As they look to maybe fight here, Loveling doesn't want to give up control of the area. But they do sweep the pink wards out.
Yeah, OMG don't want to let this dragon fall for free to IG. Zatai continuing to pull Xiong away as long as he possibly can. He does have teleport, and while in mini form, Xiong has no way to interrupt that outside of just doing damage. So Zatai could look to join up with the rest of his team. OMG grouped up in the pit. But Rookie still split on the bottom side. He could try looking for that bottom field.
He's just trying to absorb as much farm as possible. Once again, there's a bit of a ticking time bomb on the side of Invictus Gaming because of the cast, because of the Hecarim coming through. Kog'Maw, a much better late game carry than what they had in the last game, but still going to be a little bit of a difficult lane as Kakao, once again, visiting the top side of the map. Xiong is in trouble. He's going to die.
Certainly is. You can see Zatai dashes forward. Let's see if the bounce will keep him alive. Agony's Embrace, double stun, buys him time. Kakao manages to dodge the building. Xiong again with another double stun. Is he going to get out of this? Kakao's providing chase. He doesn't have vision. He gets the kill.
Yeah, but Loveling's rotating up. doesn't get through, gets spotted out by a pink ward, so it will be a kill for nothing. A lot burnt once again, though, to take Xiong out, and that ward doesn't spot.
What? What? That's odd.
Interesting.
Huh. So, cool. Sees Rookie. Rookie's like, wait, what? How did he know?
And it wasn't a spectator bug. You can see that he responded differently, so just a little bit of brush coming through there that wasn't covered by the pink ward.
Yeah. The map itself seems to be favoring OMG in this match. Oops. Not certain if Dragon is being started right now, but it seems like it hasn't been. Just clearing out some wards instead. While OMG are once again grouped up on the pitch, Xiong finally has his teleport back up, but Zetai doesn't have his onslaught of shadows. And it seems like everyone's content to just go for this laning phase. Oh, as I say it. As I say it. Literally as the words are coming out of my mouth.
Yeah, but they walk away because of Rookie showing on that ward, so everyone very tense, even though Kakao's back in base. Just a little bit of a bluff coming through. They go in.
There goes the slide. Kid can't flash the wall. He's taking a lot of damage. He gets destroyed. Teleport coming in. Kitties is low. He's trying to buy time, but it's not enough. Two quick kills onto Kool.
What a great ultimate from Kool there to knock two people back. Means that they will get at least mid lane tier 1, if not tier 2 coming through here. Because there's honestly nothing that IG can do to stop them. Rookie going to try and trade it in the bottom lane, but that's not going to be enough.
Yeah, we're seeing them take the mid tier 1. The tier 2 is going low. They bring it down and... Wait, Kao is getting blue buff.
Yeah, well, he can't defend anyway. Yeah, and it's like the only time he's ever been able to grab a blue buff. So he takes that and gets the heck out of Dodge. Maybe they can delay the Baron Dragon for long enough for the support and AD duo to get there.
Yeah,
he's running some interference.
IG have now respawned. Kid joining up with the rest of his team along with Kitties. IG are actually getting the superior positioning on this Dragon. There's no cask. There's no Emperor's Divide. So IG pulled the trigger on the Dragon. Down to 3,000. Two now, one. Will they manage to get the swipe? No, no steal. Oh, that was close. There was no smite for Kakao.
Yeah, so didn't have that available. Able to pick it up in the end, however. See, Trinity Force has been finished up for Zetai. Trinity Force and Bilge Water Cutlass also finished up right now for Kid. North being hunted.
Yeah. Luckily, butterflies have an innate sense of when predators are nearby, so.
Do they really?
No.
Okay. Well, thank you for lying. That was nice. I think that we get something there.
Yeah, North is just going to play it safe instead.
Shut up!
Now I've got the giggle.
It's all right. Sound man, please mute him. Anyway, Lovely has started up. The blue buff here on the side of OMG. You're going to look to give that one over to Kool.
Yeah, looks like Kool will be getting his blue buff finally. He's been keeping pace with Rookie in overall CS, so not doing too bad for himself despite a rough start to this game. Rookie again, looking on the bottom side of the map. Zetai doing the same on the top. While Kid and Kitties continue to farm it up in mid. Now that we've gotten out of that early contentious mid-game phase, it seems like IG have kind of lost their steam.
Yeah, a little bit, but they've also got a Rylite Crystal Scepter on their jungler, who's really strong right now. So Kakao looking to be a little bit more of a teamfight presence with the persistent slow that's going to come out. Of course, 40% always helps there. And tracking down the Trixie Gnar. Surprised he didn't go towards Abyssal Scepter. Give him a little bit more clear speed, of course, or team fight prowess there.
Ooh. Recall was completed for Kid.
Of course, last 0.5 seconds if you take damage. Doesn't interrupt the recall. So nothing to see there. North now being stalked using that butterfly sense once again.
I'd like to imagine that butterflies actually do when I'm wrong. I feel like that would make for a more fun story. Zetai continues to farm it up.
All members heading up to the top lane, though.
Yeah,
and
OMG.
That's what I'm talking about. See, Team Proc with the W. It is so hard to deal with.
Yeah, some serious damage coming out of North. Directional pings as the wave is getting shoved forward. Loveling now coming up. He will be spotted out by this pink ward.
Rookie as well as Kitties trying to head up there to see if they can dissuade Any action going to come through?
Yeah, the ward gets cleared and OMG decide to back away, especially seeing the response from Invictus Gaming, who have got some serious ward coverage on that side of the map right now. OMG do get a few deep wards of their own. Completely read IG out. 22 minutes into the game. It's about even in kills. Maybe a 2,000 gold lead in favor of Invictus Gaming, but even in Dragons, seems to be a very patient mid-game.
And this time I'm a little bit more happy for OMG to play the patient game, because as we mentioned, they've got the reset buttons, they've got the good 5v5 team fight. There's still some mid-game power to come out of this Invictus Gaming lineup, and don't get me wrong, casting a no slouch as the game progresses, but it's definitely not as one-sided as it was last time around, so Invictus probably not feeling as comfortable this game.
Probably feeling a bit of the heat. Rookie has now completed his Zhonya's Hourglass, so he does have some sustain with that. And again, split push finds North and Amazing, just follows them around the map. To make sure that there isn't anything too ridiculous. Amazing waiting just a bit out of vision to make sure he can catch North just in case things go south, but nothing does, and North heads south.
Kid also looking to see if he can sneak into any brushes. Everyone just posturing for the next dragon, you have to feel, although a nice flank coming through from Zatai and Kakao. They've spotted our Cool.
Yeah, they certainly have. Cool gets caught. There goes the Emperor's Divide. Used a bit too soon as Zatai is waiting to catch him in. Kakao gets knocked backward by Loveland. Here's Zatai. Is he going to get the Onslaught of Shadows? He's holding onto it so long. Kakao goes low. Kid's forced to flash away, and seems like Zatai just couldn't pull the trigger there. Rookie with the split shows up late, and OMG win the fight pretty handily.
The whole of the team didn't want to pull the trigger because there's only a minute left on Dragon. All they wanted out of that was the ultimate from Cool, but in the end, they end up overstaying, get shunked out, not able to defend their blue buff once again. Everyone has to go back to base, and they forfeit control over the area.
Yeah, they certainly do. Dragon's now going to be up in about a minute.
Morello, is this going to be
full AP Evelyn?
So, your colleague, David Freak Turley,
oh, God,
during NACC, had a very funny conversation with Zyrene about Nash's Tooth Evelyn.
Oh, my.
Apparently, it is a build. I haven't seen it yet, but that could be what he's going for. Of course, it could be a Morello Nomicon, which would be a little bit more standard, but Nash's Tooth, definitely a viable option.
And what does Nash's Tooth do?
I have no idea.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Before we could figure that out, Zyrene was teasing about having friends. That was a difficult conversation, but
glad to see the North American challenger scene is as lively as ever. But this is China.
It is.
This is the LPL. We're 2 weeks away from playoffs.
Nash's Tooth shouldn't be built on Evelyn. Yeah. I should add.
After this game, we'll be 2 weeks away from playoffs. A mere 24 games.
They start off Dragon. No real good ward right now. Was a tie to teleport to. They also don't have the speech run. This is dangerous.
Very tricky situation. Zatai does have his teleport.
He's teleporting on the same side, so no flank. It's going to be a head-on charge. And the Emperor's Divide is back available.
No, the Dragon has restarted. No, he's now flanking around from the back of the Dragon Pit. But Chiangardi waiting over the walls. Dragon goes low. It is secured by Kakao. He dashes forward. Do they want to pull the trigger? Seems like they can't quite.
They want it on Xiong.
Yeah, they're looking for it, but cannot quite commit to it. Zatai over the wall decides not
now
to. Suddenly,
Igen
are locked in the pit. What are they doing? They've got two wall dashes. Oh, are they going to commit to this? There goes the barrel. Rookie goes in. Is forced to drop his Zhonya's immediately. Kakao looking to join up, but Rookie dies because IG cannot follow as a team. Some serious communication issues with this. And IG are going to have to back out of this.
They all had wall hops. It wasn't two of them with wall hops. Every single one of them had a wall hop. And one of them used it to get out.
Oh no, Zatai. He's caught. Kitties completes the recall by dashing off, and he dives back in. There goes the Onslaught of Shadows. Frozen Mallet catches it.
And in the end, two members go down. Zatai and Rookie in the end fall. They do manage to grab the dragon. But this is what we mentioned in a 5v5 teamfight scenario. Kog'Maw, very hard to equal in terms of damage. And Kid just not able to do it at this point of the game. 0-2-2, not having the MVP-like performance that he had game one behind the Protect the Kid composition.
Yeah, seems like we're looking at a different team entirely with this Invictus Gaming lineup we've got on the map right now. And I've got to ask, where did they go? What happened? Why can't they team fight anymore?
Yeah, so just a little bit of miscommunication. Once again, not willing to pull the trigger. Kakao, a little bit squishier this time around. Not able to play it the way he was with Echo by running at people. He has the makings of the Morella Nomicon coming through there for some cooldown reduction, getting towards that 40%. Have to see whether they're able to successfully defend this top lane turret, which is now going to be the next focal point for OMG to probably take the gold lead.
Yeah, they do have a large minion wave up there. Foss Bomb clears a pretty big chunk of it. Recall now being completed out of cool and Lovelink. Looks like they decide not to commit to it.
And you can see how much the fourth place means to both of this team. Yeah. OMG to keep it, IG to secure it after what would be a 2-0 if they take this game. But they're just being so cautious. They never want to be in a position where one team fight is going to give away the Baron. Both teams have relatively good Baron control at this point of the game. And it's just going to come down to execution. We mentioned it a lot, but both teams relatively equal. Like Hogmore versus Cassidy. In terms of scaling, don't know really which one you would go for. But the difference is that there's just no legitimate tank on IG's lineup.
Yeah, there really isn't a tie. Going for the component build, but just cannot quite pull it off as he's completed his Trinity Force, looking now for a Spirit Vision. But it's just a little bit slow on the uptake. And we're actually seeing a pretty moderate CS lead open up for Kid on the bottom side, but as you mentioned, he's just not able to make as effective use of his overall gold as now we're getting into the late game. Hogmaw's range
is just terrifying as the game goes on. Able to keep vision on you in brushes with the ultimate. His Kid is just so, I'm going to call it oppressive, especially AD Hogmaw. AP Hogmaw is more oppressive, but AD Hogmaw just as oppressive, especially when you hide him behind a Janna, behind a Gragas, and an Azir.
Yeah.
Definitely going to mean good things as this game goes on.
So much reset ability for OMG. They managed to get a minion wave escorted to the bottom lane tier 2 turret.
This time there's a good ward. So he can go back, pick up home guard boots if he wants now, Zatai. There is a ward just over that wall.
He doesn't have teleport.
Doesn't have teleport. Good point.
Yeah, he does complete his recall. OMG expect the teleport any second now. They're even pinging out the wards for IG, but they don't see Zatai. They're going to see him any second now, and he decides to walk into ward vision. And this siege looks like it is going to be doing some damage to the
team. Young about to transform.
Yeah, he certainly is. There goes the
bot.
Meganar gets activated. Kakao dashes forward to Tai, sees Meganar, and immediately turns tail.
So
and starts to head out.
Kakao, you see, with this AP build, just did half a Kool's health in his ultimate and one eat. It's just that they cannot follow up the damage after that. They had the potential. Ooh, Kakao's looking at him.
Who's he going to go for? He finds Xiong. Looks like he turns onto him. Shop gets closed. 5-13. Kakao trying to go 2v2, but there's North. The smite comes out. He's dodging around as best he can. Flashes. They continue to provide chase. Zatai drops the ignite. Oh, Xiong tries to get some health, but cannot in time. Zatai goes down. North gets a double kill, but here's the rest of IG. Rookie should catch up to him. North goes down. A 2-for-2 trade.
Yeah, so in the end, 2-for-2 coming out of there. Some good return damage comes across for North. The Kakao, you just see how squishy he is. He's not able to have these long extended trades. It's about dumping his ultimate, a couple of Qs and flanking around the rest of the time. He's relying on Zatai to do a lot of the heavy lifting, which is why they need to continue to stall, because right now, Zatai's just not a tank.
Yeah, Zatai just cannot soak anywhere near as much damage that North is putting out. Two items completed on that terrifying Kog'Maw. Now picks up a Quicksilver Sash to deal with the constant dive coming out of Invictus Gaming.
I don't know whether I agree with that. There's not really that much hard CC on the side of IG. You know, there's the Braum stun, that's it. Maybe Terrify, you're able to QSS that if you're really quick. but there's already a Mikhail's built up. And you've got Janna, Azir, Gragas, all these champions that should be keeping people off you. and goes for the defensive option still. Magic resistance always good, but this is one of the few occasions that I would be like, just build a Hex Shrinker if you want to have magic resistance coming through there.
See OMG now posturing around the dragon as it has respawned. IG are already in position. Zatai just got his Onslaught of Shadows back up. And he's even got Teleport as well. Not a lot of wards for him to come to unless he decides to cross the river with it. And OMG grouped up in that tight choke.
Now they finally have a flank. They've got Kakao and Rookie behind OMG.
Mega Target activated. He's looking for Kid, but cannot find him in time.
The flank is here. If they continue to walk into that choke, there's a very good team fight. Spot him out with a ward.
Yeah, Kakao gets spotted by a pink ward Baron Dragon. He's been started and pulled out of the pit, but they cannot quite commit to it, knowing that the flank is possible. Meganar still on cooldown for Xion.
Yeah, he's exhausted. If there was a time to fight for IG, it was right then.
Yeah, they pull the trigger. Xion gets found. Agony's embrace is in. Activated. Cool is taking a barrier. He turns it around, but IG have dived on the north onto the back. Zatai and Rookie managed to clean it up. Rookie needs to get away. He continues to provide chase. There's the Zhonya's. He's at such low health. He flashes and gets out of there. Kid turns it around. He turns onto Cool, but the turret does some serious damage right back. OMG looks like they're going to lose this fight. Ember's Divide gets dropped, but Cool ends up going down to the burn for a Braum.
Yeah, so in the end, it is a 1-4 there. Invictus Gaming completely wiped the floor of that team fight off their back of a fantastic flank coming through from Zatai. You know, Kakao also caught out amazing at the start of that fight to chunk him low of health. They will be able to grab the dragon off the back end of this, but probably need to be careful that Baron isn't the response with Ogmore now surviving. Invictus Gaming, they get the one team fight. They can't really get too much off it.
Yeah, they definitely do that. Dragon number three now secured for Invictus Gaming. Dragon's flight buff has been picked up. King's going down to the Baron. IG know that this is a possibility. They're not taking any chances.
Yeah, but OMG, they are playing this really safe. They don't want to go anywhere near that big scary worm. North instead just eyes off some creeps in the bottom lane hungrily.
Yeah. This butterfly sounds sneaky.
I'm never going to
let you live that down. You liar.
I was trying to turn it into a Spider-Man pun, to be fair.
Spider-Man was a Spider-Man, not a butterfly void creature. As we see, as Morella and Omicron, another needlessly large rod and an elixir picked up for Kakao. He's in a very good position to fight. No CDR coming through for Rookie just yet. Has gone with a Void Star, as well as another Blasting One. Blasting One really doesn't build into that much nowadays. The needlessly large one is like the staple. Maybe something like an Abyssal coming through.
Maybe. Could be a very strong choice for his team. You already talked about the merits of that item a little bit earlier in the game. Though now we're seeing a lot more damage coming out of IG. Last Whisper finished on Kid.
Who gets tagged?
Now he's it.
Rookie's in the bottom lane. It's just whenever you see people walk in chokes like that as Evelyn, you get this really strong compulsion to hold it. Especially when you're AP.
Yeah. It's like whenever you're Rengar, when you press R, you always have to jump on someone, even if it's in the middle of fire.
Oh, good ult.
Oh, yeah, there it is. Kiddies gets caught. He's going low. He's going to go down. Cool, again, with a great Azir slide.
Yeah, and just not respecting the range that can come through on that one. They look to start off Baron now with the support down.
They certainly do have a lot of damage spreading through its health. Rookie's up there. Zatai has teleport. He's activating it now. And immediately, OMG peel off of the Baron. No home guard as Zatai looks for the flank. OMG are against the wall. But they back away. Cannot commit. They do get that teleport out, though.
Yeah, now they're trying to commit towards the top side of the map. See if they can get that. But King's down the mid lane. This would be an advantage trade right now for IG if Kid is able to pull this off.
Yeah, recalls coming out from OMG. They cannot pull the trigger. So
Kakao
many wards.
Lovely.
Yeah, he gets spotted out over the wall, though. Drops the elixir. Oh, man. Cannot quite.
But now the support AD duo. Oh, he mistimed it.
Oh, man. man.
Rookie's still here.
Yeah, he could provide some more slow. There's the teleport. Rookie, a little overextended, drops the Zhonya. Xiong trying to buy time for his carry.
Look at that.
He's at low health. There goes the slam. It's dodged by Rookie, but Zetai and Kao eat the full front. They take a lot more burst. They're forced to jump out.
The Kao has down getting used.
So much damage gets knocked out. Kitties tries to go over, and Zetai gets carried over the wall on the back of Azir's soldiers.
Yeah, but Kid goes down in the meantime. Once again, Baron, a very real objective right now, even with the jungler dead. Get the first reset out here with Janna. They're probably going to be able to take this one. Not much Invictus can do.
Yeah, there goes the monsoon. It's down to half
back
health.
Away.
They decide not to commit to it.
That's
they don't want to take any chances.
And a half health mid laner. It has 0% chance of stealing that, and OMG still don't pull the trigger.
Yeah, a lot of respect from OMG going towards IG, perhaps a little bit too much. And that might end up hurting them in the long run, as we can see they're not able to take very many objectives. Finally, they clear the top tier one turret, but that was 37 minutes in.
Just the slightest of gold lead still exists for IG. It means absolutely nothing at this stage of the game. You see that Zetai, he's finally turned into a tank. Kakao needs his Zhonya's. If this is the way he's going to play Evelynn, needs to be able to hit that no button at some point. Hasn't even been using that ulti for much survivability. And, you know, as the game progresses, the Kog'Maw just gets more and more strong.
Yeah. We're seeing North do so much damage to Kakao, though Kakao does find Loveland. There goes the explosive cast. Monsoon hasn't been used yet. Kitties cannot chase, though it looks like they might try to. There's a dash over the wall. Zetai comes in from the far side, does have the onslaught of shadows, but the moment they get into the corridor with Kool and North on the other side, they back out.
Yeah, it's just way too much persistent damage. They need to blow someone up, and Loveling is not that target. You see, he's as tanky as Zetai right now. So not the best move coming through for IG. Once again, Kakao didn't want to use the ultimate. And one. They just continue to gain control over the Baron area.
Yeah, they're playing around the vision on this side of the pit. Kakao looking to see if he can find someone out of position, but just doesn't have any wards. Xiong, looks like he might be the target. Kakao once again pulls the trigger, but Xiong bounces to safety, and Kakao takes so much damage.
Yeah, flat HP, not a great source of defense against the Kog'Maw.
Ooh, flashes to dodge the cast, gets out with his life. Ooh, that was a
that
big
was
cool
actually time. Worth, I think, right now for Kakao.
As Zetai tries to turn it into yet another fight. Once again, OMG back up into a tight choke point. IG cannot chase them. That's like the third time in a row that's happened.
It's funny because they can't chase them through a choke point, but OMG cannot walk through a choke point because right now, Kakao's ultimate does probably like 30% of their health. So you can see that they're giving him a lot of respect, and maybe this will be the fight.
IG get the fast track onto the turret. It goes down. The inhibitor has been broken. But IG cannot quite find the fight. OMG look to chase it around. They're actually dashing down the mid lane. IG are being pulled like puppets on a string. Though Kool and North are in the back.
Once again, it's only the Baron that they can threaten with. Fourth Dragon right now is available for IG if they're able to send someone off to start that one. They're baiting the Baron yet again.
Yeah, they certainly are.
Maybe shuffle Kitties back in, but he's got the advantage now.
IG are not falling for it, however. Zetai standing on top of a ward knows that it's not currently
big minion
being
waves
done.
Growing in the bottom and top lane right now for Invictus Gaming. You feel this might be the fight.
Oops, Zetai almost gets caught out there. Cool. Not able to find the Azir slide once again. His sixth sense is tingling. He finds Kakao. The cask is off. Cooldown. The fight breaks out. Rookie dives in to try buying time. There goes the Emperor's Divide. Rookie dodges the damage, but Zetai goes low. North still alive in the back, dishing out so much damage.
Xiong lifts the
ult. Bring him low. Yeah, it's huge. Xiong gets a great knock over the wall. North goes down. Cool goes low. IG are turning the fight. They find Xiong once again. And oh man, Kid goes low. The flash over the wall isn't enough for Kitties. And Cool and Xiong trade. It's a 3-for-3.
Xiong missed the ult there. Bottom lane turret goes down right now for Invictus Gaming. That creep wave is absolutely massive. And on the back end, you saw how much damage Kakao did. He completely destroyed Loveling in a 1v1. He's just not able to commit to the huge team fights. And This game is all over the place. Baron's still very much the objective with huge waves in top and bottom. As I said, fourth dragon available for IG. With the rate this game's going, you would think if they grab it soon, fifth would be a real possibility.
They're going down mid.
Well, they can't let Baron go across. They have to send Zatai to deal with that bottom lane. Because right now, they're just going to make a beeline to Baron.
Yeah, the top tier two looks like it's taking some damage. Zatai dashes out to clear out those minions. Xiong running through with Pool, but Kid is on the other side. Here comes Loveling and Amazing with North hot on their heels. The pink ward needs to be cleared for Kakao. He manages to, though it's four members of OMG
down
on the
barrel. Very low.
Here comes the teleport.
Zatai comes in.
Dashes in. OMG back out. Kakao's caught.
What at all?
Lasagna's tries to keep him alive, but he's going to die throughout this fight. IG have to try turning it around, but they can't. Kakao is dead. They don't have enough damage, and OMG are forced to back out of
it. But they still have Zatai's ultimate. Rookie is here.
Yeah, they're looking for it. Can't quite pull the trigger just yet, though. Loveland clears out yet another ward, and the Baron still on the map. Nobody's taken it, though. Giddies clears a ward. He's got to be careful. Two recalls. Xiong and Amazing are able to head back, but... Uh-oh. Kid tries to solo clear the dragon.
Yeah, no, can't do that. They started it up yet again. OMG winning this protracted game of, I guess,
tug of war?
Chicken?
Yeah. Most
anything
certainly.
You can do, I can do better. They tag up Xiong. He's about to go mega. Needs to respect
is.
It.
Baron goes low. Is he going to commit to it? Knockup denies the bounce. Zatai has got his onslaught of shadows. There goes some more damage. It looks like Baron
health.
Is going to be secured by OMG, but Zatai dashes in too late. What was he doing? Kid caught against the wall. A great ult by Xiong, and IG are falling apart at the seams. Knockup finds Kitty as North mops up yet another kill, and they're looking now to take whatever they can with this.
Yeah, but huge minion wave top and bottom. Now the situation is reversed where OMG don't have the creep wave control. They will be able to grab Dragon. That is 100% sure. Kakao's looking to see whether he can pick off a straggler. Team's still relatively grouped up. They will try and break the base right now. Still 30 seconds. They might even try and win.
They've got a bit of a window right here. Rookie waiting over the wall, getting some damage onto Amazing, but North is on the turret. He
is ready for
the turret.
They can do this.
Wait, where is Kakao going? He's trying to clank from the back side, but he just can't find a way in. They're looking to end the game. There goes the monsoon. This is getting close for OMG. Nexus turret one goes low. Rookie dashes in. Here's Kakao. Is he going to drop it? He looks for Cool. Doesn't find it. Rookie goes down. OMG could be looking to win this. The explosive cast knocks Kakao away. Nexus turret two goes
OMG
down.
Win.
OMG are screaming and they manage to. They take the win and split 1-1.
And once again, a protracted game with a hyper-scaling AD carry and mid laner coming through. This time it's OMG that are able to benefit from the ability to reset fight after fight. You could see every single time IG went in, it was like, we don't want that one, reset. We don't want that one, let's reset. And then they finally got the one they were looking for, the pick onto the jungler. They take Baron, win the game, and IG are shattered.
Oh yeah, you can just see on your screen, face in palm. Cool looking very happy after his performance in that first game. And man, IG, they played well. They played exceptionally well over the course of that game, but they ended up playing it to OMG's tune.
Yeah, exactly right. They just couldn't get the fights that they were looking for. We mentioned the snowballed Evelynn. Went an AP route with a very late Zhonya's. How different the fights would have been if that was a Zhonya's over a Rylaz earlier on in the game, being able to start them up, even over the Morellos. Can you have a look?
Yeah.
Some heavy parts on the side of IG, not looking great.
So I guess when it's all said and done, IG showed us that they are excellent at team fighting. They can team fight with the best of them. But if you have a team built around denying that team fight, disengaging, resetting, finding the proper angle, it really kind of nullifies that sort of playstyle that IG plays in.
100%, especially when you're relying on surprise. If you have a surprise attack that comes in, the flank from Hecarim, the flank from Evelynn, and then it just gets reset by a Gragas ultimate by the Monsoon coming through, you only have that weapon once every like minute or so. So then you have to go back to the drawing board, see if you can do it again. And the team on the screen just played the team fights late game at least a little bit better.
Yeah, OMG managing to split the series 1-1. They reclaim that I believe they are
fourth
place. Yeah. and put IG back into fifth place. We'll actually bring up the ladders right now and take a look at the standings. Once again, it's Edward Gaming securely at the top with 36 points. Right behind him is Xiaogu at 30, but that middle of the pack bracket. So close.
Yeah, it certainly is. You know, we mentioned them all. Snake, OMG, LGD, and Invictus Gaming. They're the real guys that are trying to push towards the top right now. Masters 3 and Vici right on their tails to round out our playoff bracket or top 8. And, you know, it's so close. 22 to 36
points. Like, within each other.
Even 1 to 8 is ridiculously close this time around.
Yeah, here at the bottom, you saw World Elite move up from 12th to 11th place right now. They're currently at 15, tied for 10th with RNG, but Unlimited Potential probably feeling a little bit of the heat, and King kind of kicking themselves like, wait, we need to be where World Elite are.
Yeah, they certainly do. You know, King, we're hoping they could make that late game run. Definitely doesn't see it's in the case. UP, maybe WE, looking to see if they can sneak in on the back end of Vici's poor performances lately, but it's going to be a very close finish.
Yeah, the LPL looks to be a very exciting closeout for the back half of this split, and it has been so close and so intense throughout the entire 9 weeks we've taken to get here, but now that the playoff brackets have been announced, it has just turned up to a completely different level.
Yeah, it certainly have, and you know, you look at the likes of LGD, QG, they really are challenging up there, and IG, OMG, they want to make a mark.
Yeah.